uniform can and will lead the United States in cooperation with the rest of the world towards that type of peace which will prevent World War III. That was 4 years ago. Do you remember that summer of casualty lists? The wreckage still smoldering on the beaches of Normandy? A time of dying, a time of destruction. For in that time, you remember, every one of us held a dream. At the lathe, at the fields, in early morning, at the kitchen window, sweating out a barrage in the line, every one of us dreamed of a time when the sound of peace would again be heard in the land, and there would be no more fear, and men would begin to build again. And in that dark time, you remember, Franklin Roosevelt looked beyond the horizon and gave us a vision of peace. And Franklin Roosevelt was dead. And what followed was the great betrayal. Instead of the dream, we have inherited disillusion. Instead of the promised years of harvest, the years of the locust are upon us. In Hyde Park, they buried our president. And in Washington, they buried our dream. One day after Roosevelt died, Harry Truman entered the White House. And 46 days later, Herbert Hoover was there. It was a time of comings and going. Into the government came the ghosts of the Great Depression, the banking house boys. In marched the generals, and out went the men who built the TVA, the Grand Coulee, the men who planned Social Security and built federal housing, the men who had dug the farmer out of the dust bowl and the workers out of the sweatshop. Yes, a time of comings and goings. The shadows of the past coming in fast and the lights going out slowly. The exodus of the torchbearers of the New Deal. I was still in the cabinet, hoping that we might yet return somehow to the course Franklin Roosevelt had charted for the nation in the peace to come. And I warned that our get tough policy would only produce a get tougher policy. Tough policy. I warned that its end was inevitable. We would have found agreement long before now with the Soviet government and with our other wartime allies. It is said that we must have a showdown or lose prestige. Truman may lose prestige. Dulles may lose prestige. But the American people will not lose prestige by demanding fundamental discussion looking towards peace.
Thank you.